Today's lesson will be covering, our learning objective will be, students will be able to use percent to solve problems, including finding the whole when given a part and a percent. Our essential question of the day is, in percent problems, how do you find the whole when given a part and the percent? Let's touch on what we learned in our previous lesson. Finding a percent of a number. A percent is equivalent to the ratio of a part to a whole. To find a percent of a number, you can write a ratio to present the to represent the percent, and find an equivalent ratio that compares the part to the whole. 2. Find a percent given a part and a whole. You can use proportional reasoning to solve problems in which you need to find a percent. 3. Finding a whole given a part and a percent. Once again, you can use proportional reasoning to solve problems in which you know a part and a percent and need to find the whole. Today's lesson, we will focus more on finding a whole given a part and a percent. Once again, you can use proportional reasoning to solve problems in which you know a part and a percent and need to find the whole. The I do question of the day. 12 of the students in the school choir likes to sing solos. These 12 students make up 24% of the choir. How many students are in the choir? Our first method we will use will be the concrete method. So we start off with 24% represents 12 students. 100 squares represents 100% of the students. Since 12 over 24 is equal to 1/2, 1 square represents 1/2 of a student. 100 times 1/2 equals 50. Our 100 squares will represent 50 students. That will be our whole. Now, let's check and see if our answer is correct by using the second method, which is proportions. Let's set up the equation as a proportion. But first, let's look at the concrete model. I'm sorry, I jumped ahead. When we look at our concrete model, we see that 24 are shaded in. We have 100 squares, 24 is shaded in. When we look at it, our ratio would be 1/2 a student, or our constant proportionality would be 1/2 a student, meaning that one box would represent 1/2 a student. It also could be represented as our unit rate. Now, method two, let's use the proportion and set up a proportion. We have 12 over a missing part, which equals 24 over 100. We'll write a proportion. 12 students represent 24%. Now, we'll find out what is our scale rate, or our scale factor, or our multiply factor, excuse me. How many times can 12 go into 24? 12 times 2 would equal 24. Now we need to find out how many times 2 can go into 100. 12 over 100 equals 24 over 100. Since 50 times 2 equals 100, the denominator would equal 100. There are 50 students in the choir. Thank you for joining the I Do section of the lesson. Please answer the questions in the Google Forms.